Being part of the Dartford Grammar School community is very important, not just for students, for staff, for parents, and they're all expected to play a part in the life of the school. We value what is rich from the past. At the same time, we relish the challenge, the exciting challenge of being successful in the future.
The history of Dartford Grammar School is interesting. Had it been in another town in Kent and had Dartford been a different kind of place, it would undoubtedly become an independent school. I'm quite pleased that it hasn't done that, but it has a rich history of over 400 years, getting on for 500 years, of serving the town and the community of Dartford.
My first impression of DGS was that it was very welcoming, and they brought me in straight away, and I knew I would fit in, and I found it the right school for me.
I thought it was a much bigger school than my other schools, but it also kind of contained a lot more traditions, and it was a lot more kind of cultural school that had more feeling to it.
Personally, I chose DGS as opposed to other schools because when I first came here for the open morning and the induction day, I spoke to students in Year 12 and Year 7, and they all told me that it was the perfect choice for them. They said that the students here seemed confident, they seemed able, they seemed bright. They inspired me to come here.
Something that is really important in the school ethos is the idea of the students contributing to the wider school community. We have a motto that we like the students to take on board, which is to enjoy doing well. And that's not only in your academic subjects, but also with cross-curricular links.
I think the thing that really sets DGS apart from other schools, and the thing that makes it special, is the middle years program and then following that the IB.
It allows the students to study a complete range of subjects, from maths to English to sciences, languages, humanity, and also another subject of their choice.
It has a great reputation, and I had a few friends here a couple of years older than me who went here and like had only good things to say about it, and I liked the feel of it when I came on an open day.
I think that the learning community makes it special because you get to learn in classes and you're not just being taught through the textbooks, the teachers interact with you.
We are given many opportunities here to learn in different ways, and the school allows us to develop our skills both inside and outside the classroom.
We have a unique curriculum at Dartford Grammar School. It's a philosophy where the acquisition of skills, internationalism, volunteering and academic rigour are at the core of learning.
So science at Dartford Grammar School is a huge part to the student lives here. We got science specialism 3 to 4 years ago, which has really driven on the quality of the science teaching at this school. The resources have now gone to a different level.
Science is taught really well, and we have a large focus on practical work throughout the school, which helped me to understand my notes and create links between other subjects.
What actually made me choose DGS was I was actually in an art course, and there's an older student, and he spoke about 7 languages, and he said 3 of them he actually learned from DGS. So then I actually chose DGS because of that.
Since 1995, the school has been an international language college, and we say quite publicly that we are a serious international language college. We teach over a dozen languages, and we value those highly at the time when it's a national disgrace that languages are in such decline elsewhere.
For 2 weeks of the year, the whole school goes off timetable, and each year group participates in a range of activities that differ from normal teaching.
The arts are a central part of life at Dartford Grammar School. We have a rich variety of activities going on. In art, we have the annual art exhibition, and looking around the school, you'll see lots of examples of some amazing student artwork. Drama has the school play every year, and in music, we have numerous concerts, including three main concerts every year. Small chamber ensembles, there's an activity for everybody, no matter what your age or ability.
There's no need to get personal.
I've recently been in the performance of Abigail's Party for part of my standard level theatre arts. It was really good to be a part of something that actually looked like a big achievement. Even to people that obviously hadn't been in it, they would have seen and appreciated it, like for it being a full and like well thought out and thoroughly practiced performance.
Creativity in the school plays a major role throughout the curriculum. This most definitely can be seen in the remarkable charitable work achieved by the students. They take on and organise a variety of exciting projects and events, bringing both staff and students together with the aim of raising money. We've had some really fun times with events like the Diversity Night, the Staff Charts Challenge. Memorable Kaika's Got Talent.
It's all right, you can move back off the edge of your seats.
All for really good causes chosen by the students.
I think the chance for everybody to get involved, Year 7 boys are able to represent the school. In the three principal sports, which are rugby, cricket and athletics. The rugby fixture list runs from September to mid-February, playing every Saturday. So I think that's character building. All sports, especially when you're playing away from home, will give an opportunity for that.
Started doing rugby from year seven. And rugby I thought was quite enjoying actually, because I enjoyed the physicality that it gave me. Enjoying hitting someone else within the laws of the game. Also, I realised starting in year seven that Mr. Jones realised me to have like good natural ability, so then that put me at an advantage to play the sport.
The achievements by boys at the school over the last few years just keep getting stronger and stronger. We've had four rugby teams in three county finals over the last 3 years. We've had a tour in each key stage in the school for the last few years. We've had two cricket teams have reached county finals, and the athletics team has just recently got into the national team final.
What I've done sort of as sports captain is promote netball and rounders, and we've just started girls rugby as well. And all the girls are really into it. They're really wanting to try new things.
Sport with the school's going from strength to strength.
What makes Dartford Grammar School really special is, without any doubt, its students. Its students are receptive, cheerful, imaginative, cooperative, and enjoy their time at school, we hope. So that's the most important thing that makes them special.
Three words to describe DGS: lively, nurturing, and friendly.
Challenging, enjoyable, and it has lots of opportunities. Traditional, enjoyable, and interesting.
Fun, helpful, and highly intelligent.
Motivational, joyful, hardworking.
Unique, inspiring, and outstanding.